Hello everyone and welcome to Let's Photoshop. In today's video, we're gonna see how to create this Glassmorphism effect that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Okay, so let's go and open Photoshop and let's go to File, New, and I will create a new document using 1920 pixels for the width, 1080 pixels for the height, 72 in the resolution, and RGB in the color mode, and I will press OK. Alright, now I will create a new layer and let's call this layer, let's see, Blur, and let's delete this background, and then I will right click on this blur layer and I will convert it to smart object. Now I need to open this smart object, so I'm gonna right click on it and I will choose edit content, and this will open it in a new tab in here. Alright, now we can place our image that we'll be using, so let's go and choose this blue shapes in here. I mean, this effect works best with shapes or spheres or something that has to do with UI. Alright, so once you place your image, you can just one click on this check mark and this will make it in here. Alright, let's rasterize this layer and then I will close this smart object and I will make sure to press yes for us to save the changes that we made to these smart objects in here. Alright, next I'm gonna press Ctrl Command J to make a duplicate and I will call this base, for example, because we won't apply any blur on this, and then I will hide this base layer for now. And I will select the blur, and you guess it, we're gonna apply a blur filter on it. So let's go to filter and choose blur, Gaussian blur. I mean, the radius pixels depend on you how many radius you want, but for this tutorial, I will keep it on 20 pixels and I will press OK. And let's delete this layer in here. All right, now we're gonna make this base layer that it doesn't have any blur or anything, we're gonna make it visible, and then we're gonna create a rectangle. So let's go to this rectangle, rounded rectangle tool actually, and make sure that you selected this one in here, and then we're gonna create a rectangle just like this, or you know, you can create a circle, whatever shape you want, but I think this looks better with this rounded rectangles in here. Alright, as you can see now, the properties will open after we finish creating the rectangles. And the reason why we choose rounded, because we don't want to apply this, the radius of the corner. So I'm gonna put like 50 pixel. And because we have this link, I can just put it in one in here and it will apply to all of them. And now we have this really nice rounded corners in here. Alright, and that's what all we're gonna do with this rounded stuff. Alright, now we're gonna actually apply some blending options on this. So we're gonna go to this FX icon and choose blending options or the layer size. Alright, now we have this layer size open. Let me just zoom a little bit to have a better view. Alright, something like this. I think it looks good. Alright, so the first thing that we are going to do in the blending options is to put the fill opacity, not the opacity in here, the fill one. We're gonna put it to 0% and this will make it disappear right now. So this way we're gonna see only the styles or the options that we're gonna apply. So the first one that we'll apply is a bevel and emboss. And as you can see, I already have the previous settings in here. So basically you want to make the style set to inner bevel and the technique smooth, and the depth is depend on how strong you want the depth to look like. As you can see, the more I put it, the more you can see it on the canvas. So for me, I would keep it very low, like 40% to 50%, and the direction set up, and the size is depend on the size of the corners. How big you want them. I want them to be very subtle like a glass, so I will put it like 5 pixels to 7 pixels, and I'm not gonna apply any soften in here. And then we're gonna go to the shading. So the angle is depend on where you want your angle. Maybe you can put it in here, and as you can see, it will make it more coming from this direction, and if you want it to be coming from this direction, it's like exactly like the light, just like that. You can just experiment with this until you are satisfied, but for me I will keep it where it was, something like that. Alright, now you can just keep the contour the way it is, and for the highlights mode, change it to overlay and make the color set white or gray. If you want not to be strong, you can put it a little bit soft gray, but I will keep it white and hope it's okay. And the same goes for the shadow mode, change it to overlay and also white, or make it like even grayish if you want, but I want it to be appearing in here, so I will keep it like that and hope it's okay. And also the opacity is 40% for the shadow and 70% for the highlight mode. All right, next we're gonna apply an inner glow to this. So I have the blend mode set to screen, and also the opacity is a little bit low, like 30%. And the color, actually this one I put it like a soft gray color, just like that, maybe not that, all right, something like that, and I'll press okay. And the same goes for the technique. You can just make sure that the source set to edge, and in here you can play with the size for you to have more corners or edges, like as you can see. And you can experiment with the blending mode too, maybe if you want to put it on overlay or color dodge if you want it very strong. So I think screen or normal, it looks best, so I would keep it screen. Maybe I would change the color to like this, all right, something like that. And the size, I would put it a little bit down to like 24 pixels. All right, and that would be all for the inner glow. Now we're gonna apply a gradient overlay. Gradient overlay, we're gonna just add a little bit of gradients on top in here, and I think I will change the blending mode of it to screen too. And as you can see, the opacity, I have it very low, like 40%. And the only thing that you need to play with is the gradient side in here. So in the gradient, you can just one click on it, and let's actually choose another gradient, like a default gradient in here. As you can see, now you will have it something like this. You can just open it, and then in this two color stop, you can select the first one and make sure that the color set white, and also the second one, it need to be white, just like that. But for the second color stop, we need to change the opacity of it. So to do that, we need to select this color stop that's above it, and make the opacity to 0% if you want, or you can make it like very low, like 7% for example. And now we have a color in the gradient that goes from color to transparency, or in this case go to 7%. So this is like the 7% in here. All right, and I will press okay. Now the same goes for the angle. You can choose whatever angle you want, and it depends where you want the gradient to start. Also you can play with it with your cursor like this. For example, let's make it come from here, from this direction. Alright, and I would keep everything in here, it's the same, and also the sign, make sure that it's set to linear. Alright, so the last one that we're gonna add is a drop shadow. And for this one, you can just experiment with the two. The color is set to a soft, like a dark gray color. And the blending mode multiply 25% with the opacity, because we don't want it to be that strong. And the distance, I put it to 3 pixels, and the size is 10 pixels. And again, the angle, it's better to keep it like 90, because we want it to be look like it's going all around in here. So, and that will be all for the layer styles or the blending options. And as you can see, we have what looks like a glass in here. All right, so for us to apply this rectangle or this glass, let's actually call it glass, we want it to be applied on this blur layer or blur smart object that we have in here. But we're not actually gonna create like a layer mask or something like that. We want it to be a little bit like interactive with it, which means that we can move it and still the blur will be applied inside the the rectangle in here. Alright, for us to do that, we're gonna select this glass rectangle. We're gonna make sure that it's selected, and also we're gonna press Ctrl Command and select the base layer that it doesn't have any blur. And then we're gonna actually make a group by pressing Ctrl Command G, and this will create a group, and we're gonna call it glass. Alright, after that we're gonna open this group and go back to this glass rectangle, and then we're gonna go back actually to the blending options again. Alright, now in the blending options in here, we're gonna change the knockout that it set 9 in here. We're gonna change it to shallow, which means now we'll go and be applied on the last layer that we have on our panel layers. Alright, so just change it to shallow and press OK. Now as you can see, this will actually not affect any base layer or anything that's inside the group, which will affect this one in here that go and be applied on it. Alright, now as you can see, if I move it, the blur will be applied on all the areas of the image. You can just put it wherever you want, but still the blur will be there. Alright, as you can see, now we have our glass morphism effect. And if you want to add more texture to this glass, you can do that. For example, you can go back to the blur layer, because if you want to add something on top, you need to go back to this blur layer. And then you can just go, for example, to filter and choose filter galleries. And as you can see, I already have this set in the distort folder. You can just choose this diffuse glow or glass if you want. There is like lots of options in here, but for this one we're gonna choose diffuse glow and put 2 in the grayness, 0 in the clear amount, and 15 in the clear amount in here, and press OK. And now we have this what looks like a grainy glass in here. And that will be all. That's our glass morphism in Photoshop. Alright, so I hope that you enjoy and you like this tutorial and it was a little bit helpful for you. If you try this, make sure to let me know, Facebook, Instagram, whatever. And don't forget to subscribe and comment and wait for more tutorials to come. And have a nice day. Thank you for watching.